What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 10 of the Ultimate Let's Play Pokemon Brilliant Diamond, and I'm recording this right after I finish with episode 9. Got a little taste of Eterna Forest, and now we're going to explore it in full. We did add Murkrow to the team. One thing I did notice that off-camera, after cruising through its EVs, it also has the ability Super Lock, which is going to increase its critical hit chances. And I can tell you how good that's going to be. So it has Peck, Astonish, and Gust. So it's got a Flying, a Ghost, and another Flying. It doesn't have any Dark moves yet. But I have a feeling in due time we will pick up a few. So anyway, we've run into this girl here, Cheryl, who we're going to escort through Eterna Forest. Let's go through this forest together. Okay. So we're going to have a little bit of company as we make our way through this maze. And I should be okay on antidotes. We're just on a power walk. Those guys were hidden. I couldn't actually see them. What's cool, you might ask? No, I'll tell you. Anyway, bug Pokemon. Alright. Maybe I should have started with Murkrow. Maybe get some Ash here. Brianna and Jack. Pachirisu and Wurmple. One has three Pokemon, one has one. I'm gonna have Chansey as my partner. Alright, so let's knock out this bug. Never don't like bugs. Level up. He's being a spark. Lucky chance he's got a lot of HP. Sweet kiss. What's that gonna do? That's gonna confuse it. Okay. Now Beautifly is coming out. Okay, this could be problematic. Let's try confusion on Beautifly. Lives. A spark. And chance to use Sweet Kiss on Beautifly. Here comes Gust. That's gonna do much. I'm gonna take a chance here and bring out Murkrow. So I want to try and level up a bit quickly here. I'll do these with these guys confused. Oh, that was a mistake. Yeah, I'm gonna exit and bring him back. Yeah, and the disarming voice comes. I wasn't even gonna take down Beautifly. Well, Staravia, it's your move now. I don't want to take out that Pachirisu. I've been too focused on the bug types. Still paralyzed. Alright, Staravia, Cricketune, and Chiyo did all level up. Here comes Silcoon. Okay. Let's do a wing attack on Silcoon. Thanks, Chansey, for healing me. Yeah, took down Silcoon. Stradia levels up. I'm gonna Sweet Kiss to throw this guy into confusion. trying to get him to attack himself. Get a quick attack again. Please attack yourself. Not once. Let's go put Staravia in the red here. I would prefer if you just attack. I guess this will work too. One more quick attack should finish off Pachirisu. Got him. Dabra's now at level 18. Wow. I don't want to get too far ahead. Oh, you. It bugs me when people ignore the awesome coolness of bug Pokemon. Alright. Well, Cheryl actually just healed everybody, so let's do a quick tag out here. I'm going to bring in, now let's bring in Weasel. He needs to learn some, water moves. I'm going to put Murkrow up front. Grab this item, a paralyzed heal. Nice. Looks like we got another double battle here. When a trainer and Pokemon bond is won, a wondrous power is born. I see it. I see it. I see you going down in defeat. Are you psychics? I guess so. Elijah and Lindsay. Abra and Abra. I just hope they don't have Charge Beam. That would be a very unfortunate chance. Bummer I don't have any Dark moves yet, but I do have Astonish. These guys are level 15, wow. Energy Ball, that's a Grass-type move, but shouldn't do too much damage, especially when going up against Chansey. So these guys have Energy Ball, okay. I can work with this. This would be a good opportunity for Murkrow to get some experience here. Or let me get my attacks out. I've had the worst luck with confusion in this game so far. Okay, that's one Abra down. We're going to get a level up as will Geodude. I learned Haze, which I think just eliminates all stat changes. Judy wants to learn Rock Throw. Good, he's gonna learn Rock Throw finally. I'll get rid of I got nothing but rock moves, but whatever. Once I learn some ground moves, then we'll be set. Get to Astonish again. Itself and did a lot of damage to itself. Wow. Did that take it out? It was a critical hit. Well, that's that super lock kicking in, increasing my critical chances. Alright, excellent. Maybe Elijah and Lindsay. Is it I that have gone down in defeat? Down here. Great Ball. Our first Great Ball of the game. The more powerful version of the Pokeball. And I see a couple of bug trainers here. Should be easy pickets for Murkrow. My senses tingle. I spotted a rare Pokemon. Here comes the swarm. And here comes the bird. And he's hungry. Wow. So Donald and Philip. Wurmple and Burmy. Looks like it's Murkrow's feeding time. Let's see what Gus does. knocks that level out of commission very quickly. Dustox, the other form of the ball form of Wurmple. We'll go ahead and use Peck. Want to take this guy out. And this guy sleep as well. Well, he's not doing that much damage to me either. Super luck there, but yeah, okay. It's gonna be big for Murkrow. Two levels, one for Krikatoon, one for Weasel, one for Monferno. And disarming voice, is that gonna, what's that gonna do to Burmy here? Stays confused. And use tackle. Take out this Cascoon now. Oh, it survived. That's where Disarming Voice could have probably came in handy. Well, I'm not gonna worry about Cascoon now. All it knows is Harden, I believe. I'll focus on taking Burmy out now. Honestly, the Disarming Voice could have finished the battle right then and there, just for the record. I'm not controlling Chansey Dragon. He's gonna try and use Fury Cutter on us. Now, had we been in a better position, that would be quite an effective strategy. With Fury Cutter, attack doubles every consecutive hit, but if you don't get a chance to get multiple hits, it's kinda useless. And now Murkrow's gonna learn Wing Attack. Okay, so I'm gonna get rid of Gust. As this, my my physical attack is gonna be significantly better than my special. So if we're getting Gust, we're gonna get Wing Attack instead. You to do levels up to 17 as well. I hope it learns magnitude at some point. I know it will, just don't know when. Ow, 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 ow. Whoa. They're speechless. Looks like Path Divine's here. Grab a potion. More wild Pokemon. Another Murkrow and another Buddy Murphy. Yeah, I'm not really gonna bother with these guys. Enforce the keys. There are many items on the ground that cannot be seen. That can't be seen in the murky darkness. Take the time to search carefully. So yeah, you can. I think at some point we'll get some kind of item finder. Making sure I'm not missing anything here. And now we got two wild Silcoon. Well, since they're Silcoon, I might as well just go ahead and take them out. No chance he'll be here to heal up. A though it wasn't a kill. Now I'm questioning whether or not it's worth it. Had that been a one-hit KO, maybe I should have used, did I use Wing Attack or did I use Peck? I used Peck. Alright, I should use Wing Attack. I'm gonna just go run. Alright, so... anyway... Murkrow and Lemuri. I'm not really interested in catching Pokemon right now. I'm just gonna try and get through this forest here. Keep getting hung up on the... I just did a full circle here. Even down here. I'm just gonna put on a Repel. Okay, we got a Budu and a Bunny. Should have some repels on me. I do. Okay. So I'm protected for 100 steps. Yeah, I've already gone this way, so alright, gotta advance now. Guess let's use another one. Another jar of honey. These are all cut trees, so can't go up there apparently. And we made it to the end, it looks like. Oh, there's the exit. I'm so relieved we finally got here. I would have never been able to get through this by myself. Thank you so much, T.U.G. And now we can actually explore on our own. So, if we want to, maybe search for more wild Pokemon or what. Anyway, let's... how much further do we have to go to Eterna City? Okay, so we've got a little small route here. We've just got some fishermen here, a wild area here, another honey tree. So I'll go ahead and slather this bark with honey. And then I'll go ahead and harvest those berries up there. What do we got here? We got orange berries. Looks like another orange berry tree here. I think this is Petcha Berry. Yep. And I think this is Cherry Berry right here. Yes. Just trying to guess them off the sprite there. So we'll plant one of this. I'll plant a Cherry Berry. And I'll plant two orange berries. I'm just gonna basically recycle. Now we can see what Pokemon are over here. Looks like more of the same. Kicking in. Now let's see what these fishermen are all about here up on this bridge. Actually, is there anything over here? Oh, this is the other route that if I had cut, I would have taken over here. Okay. Nothing over here. Okay. I'm thinking I may want to, I don't want to go into the Poketch here. Let's switch it up a bit. Geodude out. Let's bring Budu back in. And let's bring Luxio in as well. And I'm actually going to go ahead and lead off with Luxio. Because these guys got water Pokemon. Well, sit back and fish casually, it's a grown-up's hobby. Landed myself a feisty trainer. Let's go. Alright, let's see what you bring to the table here. Fisher Joseph. You have one Pokemon, and it's a Goldeen. Using your Goldeen as bait. CO. Why don't we give this guy a little thunder shock alarm clock? I'm gonna try water pulse. This can actually confuse me if I'm unlucky, which I am apparently very unlucky. But I still got the thunder shock off. This guy as well. Thunder Fang will be probably recommended. Weasel leveled up. I'll let a big wind slip away. Alright. Nothing's fine, so I can use a break, I suppose. Alright, we got a guy with six Pokemon, Fisher Andrew. Is this all Magikarp? Did I find the Pokemon trainer in this game that has a six Magikarp team? I think we found him. So this guy's just gonna basically be wasting my time. Alright, Luxio leveled up. Another Magikarp. This may be the part of the episode where you may want to just get up, stretch, grab a snack or something. Because this is going to take me a few minutes here. Levels up at least, so that's good. Maybe to spice things up a bit, let's bring in Budu. Why not? Now, will Absorb be enough to take it out in one shot? Yes, it will. Okay. Silence for a while. It looks like she's been wanting to get some action here. And what a way to get some action with grinding out on Magikarps here. Oh, this one actually lived. We used the almighty splash attack. That attack does absolutely nothing. Murkrow's gonna get a level up. Yes, this guy had nothing but six Magikarp. Now, if these were Gyarados, this would probably have ended a lot of differently. Although I did have Luxio, and, well, Thundershock may not have been enough to take down a whole herd of Gyarados. I don't know. Oh well, I should have been more serious about this. Yeah, no kidding. Alright. Looks like we've got one more on this bridge here. I finished up some sub Pokemon, let's have ourselves a battle. Alright, let's see what you got here. Okay, three Pokemon, Fisher Zachary. Really? We're doing this again? This is only three. Do you ever have deja vu? This can be something different now. Goldeen? Okay, we can do some of this. Let's keep Luxio on the field. Hopefully we avoid that supersonic there. just get a level up. It's at level 18 now. Wow. Wants to learn Sing to try and put opponents to sleep. Guess we'll get rid of Pound. I would like to have a status move in case I need to use Cricket Tune for catching Pokemon. And now another Magikarp. Well. That Goldeen was the biggest threat you had. I'm disappointed. Losing against my emotions all knotted up. Yeah, I know you bored me half to death. Alright, grab this item over here. It's another potion. And that's just the honey tree. And I think we finally made it to Eterna City. Feels great riding a bike with the wind in your face, doesn't it? Hey, you. Yeah, you, trainer. It's okay. Never mind. You look tough. I won't take... I'll just let you keep your Pokemon. Carry on. Well, alright, this is looking ominous. You already have, Galactic Grunts all around town. Underground Man's House. Dig it down for venture. I wonder if we're getting close to the Grand Underground. Have you seen our building? Team Galactic is so secret rich we'd have one built instantly. My friends at Team Galactic took his favorite Pokemon away. I don't think he's telling the truth. Team Galactic looks so cool. They don't look like common ruffians. I don't know about that. Rad Rickshaw Cycle Shop, get on and ride. Well, they say this is an old city. Doesn't look it though, not with all these tall buildings. I wonder if we can grab a bike now, or what we need to do. The man just gone off to the Team Galactic building and hasn't returned. I wonder what's holding him up. So let's see if we're gonna maybe knock Team Galactic out of the Eterna City before we can get ourselves a bike. That's unfortunate. We'll check this out later. What else is there to look? Oh, who do we have here? Oh, is that Pokedex? You must be helping Professor Rowan. What's your name? Oh, hello, T.U.G. I'll be sure to remember that name. My name is Cynthia. I'm a trainer just like you. I've been studying Pokemon mythology lately, just out of curiosity. Here in Eterna City, there's a statue of an ancient Pokemon. According to myth, it was an extremely powerful Pokemon. Who knows, you may encounter something like this while you're traveling with your Pokedex. Try using these, they should help you on your way. You get TM93s, another set of these. Cut in the Hidden Moves app allows you to chop down small trees that are blocking your way. Or you can use the Hidden Move Cut for your Pokedex in the field. Will you build places that were previously inaccessible to you, such as you spots in Eterna Forest, I can tell you that right off the gate. That's important for filling up your Pokedex, right? Then luck be with you, young trainer. But what she neglected to mention was you need the Eterna Gym Badge before you can use Cut. Well, let's finish exploring the city a bit. Most of the herb shop, home effective yet inexpensive medicine. Well, the thing is with herbal medicine, they are cheaper and are pretty powerful, but they will decrease Pokemon's happiness, and I don't want to use those. Somewhere along with that, herbal medicine doesn't bitter. That'll be a medical breakthrough. Herbal meds work most impressively, but your Pokemon won't like them. They're horribly bitter and smelly. Yeah, I'll, go with the... normal stuff here. They say this is Pokemon that lived long, long ago. There's some writing on the Pokemon statue. Dia, once created, brought time into being. In laughter or in tears, the same time flows, such as the blessing of Dia. The text is barely legible and is faded completely in places. Sounds like the legendary Pokemon Dialga. This is gonna take us to the next route. I think, and it's Route 211, so we're not ready for that yet. Hey, you there, kids. Stay away from that Pokemon statue. Team Galactic is conducting an official investigation there. Oh, really? Sometimes we're going to be touching that later on. It's certainly came to be long ago in honor of an ancient Pokemon. Though many things have changed, what is important has not. I hope it remains that way forevermore. Have you seen the Pokemon statue? When I was a wee old child, it used to be the centerpiece of many festivals. And now it seems like it's hiding something involving Team Galactic. Team Galactic Eterna Building, we want your Pokemon. Alright. Isn't there a gym around here? That's the bike shop, that's the Pokemon. There's more stuff down here. Since visiting Eterna, you need to get yourself a bike to take a ride down Cycling Road, which I think is down this way. Going underground with explore our kid is a blast, isn't it? Well, we haven't touched that yet. We will. Just gonna finish exploring Eterna, then we're probably gonna end the episode. This house is completely empty. And here's the gym. Okay. Gym leader Gardenia, master of vivid plant Pokemon, so I think now would be a good time to go ahead and heal up. At least we can get the name ring services if we go into the condominiums here, but really don't need to. I don't nickname my Pokemon. Alright, let's head to the Pokemon Center. I'm gonna go ahead and heal up and probably set my team. Hi, healer trainer. What kinds of Pokemon are with you? This Poketch app will show you how close your Pokemon feel to you. So we got the Friendship Checker for the Poketch. Okay. The Friendship Checker identifies the Pokemon that like you. Team Galactic took my Pokemon away. They took other people's too. Something should be done, but Team Galactic creeps everybody out. What are they doing to my Pokemon? I don't know, but I'm gonna get them all back. Let's heal up. Alright, thank you very much. My Pokemon fans use a revive on the Pokemon, it'll be able to battle again. By the way, I did get TM93, which is cut, so I could teach it to a Pokemon. Guess I could give it to Budu, give him an additional attack. I'm not going to use Worry Seed at all. Alright, so now, let's set my team for the gym. I'm guessing I gotta do the Pokemon gym first. So we'll put Zubat, Krikatoon, Staravia, Murkrow, Kadabra, and Monferno. I think this should be a very solid team. This is gonna be an almost unbeatable team for a grass Pokemon user, so. Alright. At this point, I'm gonna go ahead and call quits here. And I believe in the next episode we'll be taking on the Eterna Gym and then trying to see what we can do about Team Galactic. So until then, this is T.U.G saying be smart, be safe, have fun. Later, gamers.